everybody, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet this absolutely beautifully textured popcorn flower square. Now, all the information for the yarn I have used for this blanket that's currently on my table is in the description box down below. Now, please be aware, this is currently a work in progress for me. I'm only 50 something squares into my full blanket, so I don't know the exact yarn amounts I'm going to need. One thing I have worked out already though, which you may or may not find useful, is out of one ball of this yarn, I can get 20 of these popcorn flower centers themselves. So that might help you. The gray yarn goes a lot further than the popcorn itself because it can be a little bit yarn hungry. So with all that said and done, let's leap straight on into how you crochet this beautiful square. To begin, I'm going to start with a magic ring. Now, if you don't know how to do a magic ring, I have got a nice slow video on exactly how that's done, which will have popped up just up here. Or if you absolutely detest the magic ring and can't abide using them, you could substitute this out by chaining 5 and then slip stitch to that very first chain you made to make your ring that way. So with all that out of the way, into my magic ring, I'm going to place 8 single crochet stitches. Once you have your 8 single crochet stitches, go ahead and close the ring, but don't pull it all the way shut. We need to work into this very first single crochet of the round, and if we pull it too tight at this stage, you will lose that stitch. So just pull it closed a little bit. Then we're going to slip stitch to join to that very first single crochet that you made. Now round 2 are the popcorn stitches themselves. The first popcorn stitch of every round is going to be slightly different to the rest of them, so I'll show you how to start and then how to do a standard popcorn stitch as we go. So straight away we're going to chain 3, which counts as your first double crochet stitch. And then working into that exact same stitch where you just chained from, place 4 double crochet stitches, all into that same stitch. So that's 1, 2, 3, and 4. This will be how we start the beginning of each popcorn row. Chain 3 and 4 double crochet stitches, all into the same place. Now to complete your popcorn stitch, you're going to lift that loop up just so you don't lose it and take your hook out. Then you want to insert the hook into the top of your chain 3. If you have trouble identifying it, you've got the little V's of your stitch here. You'll have 4 of these, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and then your chain 3 is right at the very end here. So just pop your hook into the top of that chain 3. Then you're going to pick that loop back up, either physically put it on the hook or you can scoop it up with your hook, pull it nice and tight, and draw this loop through this loop here. So we're just going to pull it all the way through and then chain 1 to secure the popcorn stitch in place. Then chain 1 again, which will be your chain 1 space. And we're going to work a popcorn stitch into the very next single crochet. Now the full popcorn stitch is 5 double crochet stitches, all into that same stitch. So we're going to go ahead and place 5. That's 1. That's 2. That's 3. 4 and 5, all into the same stitch. And just as before, pull your hook out, And we're going to work into the very first of those five double crochets. So count backwards, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Pop your hook under the V's, both of them there, of that stitch. Pop that loop back on your hook and pull it tight. Then pull that loop through the stitch, all the way through. Then chain one to secure it. Chain one. Now we're going to repeat that tiny little section of popcorn stitch, chain one, popcorn stitch, chain one, in each of these remaining six single crochets. If you find your stitches are overlapping, feel free to pull them over a little bit so you can identify where the next stitch is. So your popcorn stitch is 5 double crochet. Take your hook out, go into the first double crochet of those 5, pop the loop back on your hook, draw it through, and chain one to secure it. Then chain one again. Keep doing that until you have 8 popcorn stitches and 8 chain one spaces in total. So I'm just finishing up my last popcorn stitch, my final chain one. And then once you're happy that you have 8 popcorns with 8 chain one spaces in between, to finish the round, we're going to slip stitch into the chain one space in between those first 2 popcorns. So skip this popcorn entirely and slip stitch into the chain one space. And now is the time to tighten up that magic ring at the back. For the third round, we're going to start with our beginning popcorn, just as we did before, which is chain 3, which counts as your first double crochet, and then 4 double crochet stitches. And we're going to be working into this chain one space in between your popcorn stitches of the row below. That's 1, that's 2, that's 3, and that's 4. So you have 4 double crochets and your chain 3. Then pop your hook into the top of the chain 3 itself. Draw that loop through. chain one to secure it. Then chain one, and we're going to place another popcorn stitch into this exact same place. Now, it doesn't seem like there's much room, so you're going to have to scooch that first popcorn around. Just get them out of the way. And we're going to do a second popcorn stitch, just as we did the remaining seven in the last round, with five double crochet stitches, all into that chain one space. One, two, three, four, and five. Secure it with the chain one to finish. So you'll have popcorn, chain one, popcorn, all worked into that chain one space from the round below, in between your two popcorn stitches. To continue, you're going to chain one, and into the next chain one space, popcorn, chain one, popcorn, all into that same space. So just as you have been doing your five double crochet popcorns, then chain one. Remember, the chain one you do to secure your popcorn stitch is not the same as the chain one space. So you'll do your popcorn and chain one to secure it, then chain one, do another popcorn, secure it with your chain one, then chain one. So you want to have a chain one space in between every single popcorn that you do. So in the last remaining six chain one spaces of the row below, you're going to place popcorn, chain one, popcorn, then chain one, before moving on to the next space. You'll have 16 popcorns and 16 chain one spaces by the end of this round. So I'm just finishing up my very last popcorn of this third round. It's my popcorn done, my final chain one space. And then to finish this round, just like we did on the round below, skip this first popcorn and slip stitch into the chain one space in between those first two. So we're just going to go ahead and slip stitch. Now that's the flower motif done. So go ahead and chain one, snip your yarn, leaving a decent length to weave in. Pull that yarn through, pull it tight, that'll hold for now. Weave in both these ends and then grab your colour for squaring off. So with your new color of yarn, you want to attach it to any one of these chain one spaces on the round below. It doesn't matter, just in between any popcorn area. Just pick a chain one space and then add your yarn as you usually would, either with a slip knot or just by drawing it through. Now, before we begin rounds 4 and 5, just a note before we start. I am using the join as you go technique for my squares on my blanket. I'll be touching on that briefly during this video, but if you'd like a more in-depth look at how to do join as you go, I have a link to that video in the description box below, or a little card will have popped up over here. Now, because I'm doing join as you go, it means I will be doing a chain one on the side sections. Now, if you're following me and you're doing join as you go, carry on, we're absolutely fine. But if you are someone who prefers to sew your squares together or join them in a different way, crocheting them together afterwards, you might want to omit that extra chain one if it makes your squares too baggy. Totally personal preference as to whether you put it in or not. I just wanted to put that disclaimer in now. It works for me for join as you go. It might not work for you having that extra little chain if you're not. So with all that out of the way, let's go ahead and start round 4. So for round 4, we're going to chain 3 to start. This counts as a double crochet stitch. Then place another double crochet into that exact same space. Then chain 1. Into the next chain one space, place 2 half double crochet stitches. Half double is yarn over, go in, drop a loop. You'll have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And another half double crochet into that same space. Chain 1. In the next chain one space, 2 single crochet stitches. Chain 1. 2 half double crochets in the next. Chain 1. And then we reach a corner section. Now in the corners, again, bit of personal preference as to how many chains you like to do in the corner. Feel free to mix this up for your personal preference. But for mine, I've been doing 2 double crochet stitches. Chain 2 and then 2 double crochet stitches back into the same place. That forms your corner. Then we're back onto a side again, so chain 1 into the next chain 1 space, 2 half double crochet stitches. Chain 1, 2 single crochets in the next chain 1 space. Chain 1, 2 half double crochets in the next chain 1 space. Chain 1, and then we're back to a corner, which is 2 double crochet, chain 2, and 2 double crochet, all into the exact same space. Then we're back to your 2 remaining sides. So chain 1, 2 half double crochet stitches. Chain 1, 2 single crochet. Chain 1, 2 half double crochet. Chain 1, and then you're on your corner, which is 2 double crochet, chain 2, 2 double crochet stitches. Then chain 1, 2 half doubles. Chain 1, 2 singles. Chain 1, 2 half double crochet. And I will meet you back here to finish off this final corner and the end of the round. All right, so these are my final 2 half doubles of this round, the sort of squaring off round. And to end the round, chain 1, and working back into this starting space where you first joined your yarn, we're going to end with two double crochet stitches, chain two, then slip stitch to your initial chain three of the round, right back when you very first started. Then slip stitch under the first double crochet that you did. I'm just working my way along, and then slip stitch into the chain one space. So I've just crept with slip stitches across those two stitches below, and I'm ending in the chain one space. Now the fifth and final round is the round on which we will be joining as we go. So let me just grab my work in progress blanket. And as this is my first square of the next round, I'm starting right on the corner. As I mentioned, I do have a nice detailed video on how to do join as you go, but the absolute basics of it is where you join, you substitute out this chain one for a slip stitch on the adjoining square. All right, your final round, we're going to go ahead and chain three, which counts as your first double crochet stitch. And then into that very same chain space, we're going to place a double crochet. Oops, grabbed my tail by mistake. Then chain one. I'm not joining on this side yet. And into the next chain one space in between your stitches, two double crochet. This is a super simple round. Chain one, two double crochet into the next chain one space. Chain one, two double crochet into the next chain one space. That's all we do on the sides for this round. Chain one, and then I am at a corner. Now for my corners on this joining round, I'm actually going to be chaining three instead of chaining two, purely because that makes the maths for my poor brain just easier to work with. So because I'm going to start joining on this side, I'm only going to do half my corner. So into this first half, I'm going to do two double crochet, chain one, then slip stitch into the adjoining chain space of the square I want to join to, and then chain one again. Then back into my corner, two double crochet. So I've formed and attached my corner all at the same time. Now, this is my joining side, so I won't be chaining one in between my two double crochet. I'm going to be slip stitching into the chain one space of this square I'm joining to. So I'm straight away going to slip stitch to join, and then work two double crochet into the next chain one space. And I'm going to do this all the way until my next corner. So two double crochet, slip stitch. So now I am back to a corner. So again, I'm going to start the corner with two double crochet. Chain one, and then I'm going to ignore this first square. I'm done with this one, and I'm going to slip stitch into the chain space of this second square. I cover this in a lot more detail as to why I'm doing this in my other videos, so please do check those ones out. Then chain one again and complete your corner by popping two double crochet back into it. So that's my joining section of my squares complete. Just rotate my entire blanket. So for the rest of this square, I'm going to be chaining one and putting two double crochet stitches into each of the chain one side spaces. So chain one, two double crochet, chain one, two double crochet. And then in my corners, I'm going to do two double crochet, chain three, two double crochet. So I'm just finishing up my final side here. I've got one more corner section to fill in. Then to finish, chain one, slip stitch to the top of that first chain three that you made, chain one, snip your yarn, leaving an end to weave in afterwards. Weaving in your ends is so important, so make sure that you are leaving yourself a decent amount of tail. Pull that loop through, pull it tight, and your popcorn square is complete. So a tiny, tiny note about this join-as-you-go method with my chain ones on the side. As you can see in the center of my blanket, where I have my squares joined on all sides, they are lovely and square. You can see throughout the body of the blanket, perfectly square. On the edges, you can see because of that chain one, it bows out slightly. This is why I was saying you might want to omit that if you are going to sew your squares together rather than join as you go. However, this will be fixed the minute a border gets put onto this blanket. So if your sides are wobbly like this, don't worry. You can see, even if I just gently pull it that way, how it instantly squares up. So don't be alarmed if your sides of your blanket are curved. You can see the final thing is beautifully square where they are joined, and a border will fix any issues you have with a slight curve at the end of your project. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I hope you go on to make beautiful popcorn flower blankets of your own. Please do give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. And until next time, happy crocheting. Bye.